Good morning, Jaguars. I'm Hannah Ramirez, and I'm one of the Career Peer Advisors here with Student Employment Services at Career and Transfer Connections Department. So in the past, we've used a resource called Optimal Resume, but today we're going to be introducing you to the new and improved SkillsFirst website. So Victor Brown, our job specialist, is going to be helping me out today to show you how to navigate the website. So after watching this video, or even before, you can click the video description for the link to SkillsFirst. So once you get that link, what you're going to want to do is make sure to log in with your student email when you are creating your account. It might ask you a couple questions for first-time users, and make sure to answer them because that's going to help make your resume as accurate to your needs as possible. So we're going to go ahead and sign in. Alrighty, so once you reach the dashboard, you're going to notice cool options like creating a resume, creating the cover letter, pitches, practice interviews, career advice, and career assessments are offered. But for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to be focusing on creating resumes. And we're also going to be providing an overview of the website, but we're going to focus on the templates for our students who are new to resumes and or not as experienced with technology. So before we move forward, I want to draw your attention to the stats dashboard. So it's important to know where this is because this is where you can see your drafts and content you have worked on. Currently, if you look over here at the resume section, it shows the number 2. So that's the amount of resumes we've currently created. This is helpful when you're creating resumes for multiple jobs, and you can also label and organize the different resumes. So now we're going to get started. We're going to go ahead and click the resume, create resume button on the dashboard. So it's going to show us 3 different options, which are uploading a resume, which I would recommend if you already have a previous resume and you're just trying to get specialized keywords. Editing sample is the one we're going to be working on today, but also we have the start from scratch option. So let's go ahead and click on edit sample. So we're now going to be brought to gallery of templates, and you can click preview template to view the options. So my favorite is Carter, so let's go ahead and just click on that one. Once we've now selected it, it's going to show you a list of options of different resumes you can use. But what's easiest to do is if you go on the search bar, you can look up a keyword for a specific type of position you're applying for. For example, cashier or accountant. But for the sakes of this resume, most of you are going to want to use the first option, which is our general or limited experience template. This is perfect for students who are looking for part-time work or just don't have a lot of job experience. So we're going to go ahead and click preview. Alrighty, so far it looks good. So if we end up liking this template, we're going to go ahead and click use the sample. When we get to this template, it's going to show each resume section indicated by a tab at the top. So now that we're brought to the document, we're going to go ahead and press the edit button. Now that we're on editing mode, it's going to show different tabs at the top that we can navigate to edit each section. So in each section, examples are going to be provided, which you can edit to match your own experience. Also, something important I want to let you guys know that as you go ahead and edit each section and add information, we're going to want to press the save button. For a moment, I'm going to draw your guys' attention to one of my favorite features, which is going to be above the tabs. That's our AI keyword suggestions. So if you go ahead and click on that, if you have a specific job in mind, what you can do is you can go to the job posting. We're going to use a job from Handshake as an example, which is our job platform, by the way. And if you guys are interested in learning how to navigate it, in the video description, we'll also attach our video that talks about how to use Handshake and what it's for. Alrighty, so going back to that job posting, what I like to do is go to the requirements section, and we're going to copy that. And then we can go ahead and paste in the AI keywords. So we're going to press get suggestions. And once we do that, it's going to highlight all of the keywords we should be applying and which sections we should be putting them in. So you can copy and paste them. And this is a really great tool to use to save time and also get past the resume section into the interviewing phase. So we're going to make sure to save our changes between completion of each section. And we can always go back to the preview button to make sure that the section looks correct. All right, so it looks good. Now we're going to go back to the edit button once we make sure that everything looks right. And we have the option to even add sections if you would like to. And it can provide you a list of commonly used sections. Also, another button that's important to note is that there's a reorder sections button. Okay, perfect. So this is going to allow you to put the sections in the order that you prefer. So once we know where the add new sections button is, it's also important to know how to rename the sections. So when we get into the edit mode, if you go to the left, you can click edit section names. You would want to do this if you want to make it a more accurate description, for example, changing it from professional experience to relevant experience. Perfect. And also another great thing to note is that if you no longer like the template you're using, you can go back to if you go back to preview, there should be a change template option. And there you'll get redirected back to the gallery, and I'll just apply the information you've already put in to a new template. So with knowing this, that's pretty much gist of how to navigate this and create our resumes. So I hope this helped you out, most of you today. And the last thought that I want to leave you guys with is that once you complete your resume, there's a green button that says submit for review. So once you press that, here at Student Employment Services, we can receive it and provide you with feedback. We can't wait to help you out, and comment below any features you would like to see us review. Also, like and subscribe for more of our content.